In the process of joining Passione, one must first pass a test of trust, orchestrated by one of the boss's closest allies, that being the only man he trusted with the stand arrow, his capo, Polpo. The test itself is structured to show both loyalty to the gang, but also allow Polpo to understand where he should place you among the gang. It's also very possible that other capos in Passione have their own test, though if it is true, be them harder or easier than the lighter test, it doesn't really matter, since the lighter test itself is structured perfectly to get the best results. Now, Polpo's lighter test is one that appears very simple on the surface, but when you look at all the small details about it, you realize that it is structured in a way to only pull the best of the best. So, let me explain the aspects of the test itself, seen through the Entering the Gang arc of Golden Wind. So let's start first with how you even get to the point where you can take the test. First, you need to earn a meeting with Polpo, and given his status as a high-ranking capo in Passione, you would first have to befriend or earn a recommendation from a current Passione member, especially one that Polpo trusts. So that means you already have to be talented in some regard to earn a meeting with the man in general. This method is done both because it helps thin out the talent pool of people trying to enter Passione, but it's also because Passione members are the only people who could set up a meeting with Polpo, as he is located in a giant prison. A prison which also seems to be based off of the famous, or I guess more accurately, infamous prison in Naples, the Poggioreale prison. Then you move on to the next step, which happens after you actually enter the prison for a meeting. You're given a single task by Polpo, and that is to keep the flame of his lighter lit for 24 hours. Now, of course, this task doesn't sound difficult in the slightest on the surface, because first, you don't even need to hold down the fork of the lighter to keep the flame going, or refuel it at any point, because the lighter is just constantly going. You just need to keep the flame from going out. But right before you start to think this is easy, you're suddenly hit with the realization that you would need to get a lit lighter out of the prison now, meaning that somehow you need to palm a lighter past armed security without extinguishing the flame, and that is one of the major parts of the test. It's probably the wall that most people hit, and is likely the reason that Polpo chooses to conduct this test within a prison, because he can leave at any point. This is especially true if you take into account that the test was designed for those without stands, so the person would be left with only three real options that would get out of the prison with the lighter in hand, which each of these three options shows something very interesting about that said person, which then helps Polpo understand where they might belong in Passione. First, you have option one, and it's probably the most common option, which is to extinguish the flame and then store it somewhere on your person, and try to relight it when you're outside of the prison. This option would result in Black Sabbath appearing and then enforcing the true test upon you. This would then result in either someone dying because they weren't good enough, or a specialist stand user, who would then go on to work as one of Polpo's grunts, possibly placed in one of the few districts that he runs, like Bruno's gang or Sally and Mario. Next, you have option two, which is finding a way to store the lighter on your person while it is still lit, much like how Giorno attempted to do when he cupped the lighter with his hands, but this would have to be placed in somewhere that the guards wouldn't check. Maybe pulling a whole Jotaro cigarette lighter trick, the roof of your mouth be damned, but this level of commitment to the gang would likely put you onto the grunt position, but not like the stand using grunts, more like a leaky-eyed Luca or how Polpo perceived Giorno after his test was complete. Someone Polpo can use to run districts like the airport or something. And then you have option three, which is straight up bribing the guards, which seems to be a pretty standard solution for a lot of issues with the law when it comes to the police in Naples, as they appear to be easily bribed by anyone, Passione or not. It's actually one of Giorno's go-to solutions for some of his earlier problems, and the news of this bribery would likely reach Polpo in his cell, and it would demonstrate your ability to negotiate well, which could land you an information management position in the gang if you pass, like other Passione members, Gelato and Sorbet, who are actually indeterminate stand users. I don't think it was ever stated if they had a stand or not. But anyway, no matter which option you go with, getting out of the prison itself is only step one. You must now then protect the lighter for 24 hours, which this step varies in difficulty depending on your own personal life, as the lighter, if left untended, would be blown out by someone else, as they might view the fire as a fire hazard, any rational person would. Or if a gentle breeze comes along and does your lighter dirty like it did its inspiration, we'll get to that in a second, you'd be shit out of luck because the flame coming out of the lighter is actually very weak. Now, during the protection period of the test, we see something very subtle yet very genius on the side of Polpo, as since the lighter itself is a source of light, that means that if it's ever extinguished and relit in any natural setting, it will be impossible for there not to be shadows for Black Sabbath to appear from, as the lighter would just create shadows with its own flame, meaning that his appearance is guaranteed. But let's theoretically say that you manage to protect the lighter for the given amount of time, and now you reach the final and most arguably difficult part of the test, which is returning the lighter to Popo by sneaking the lit lighter through prison security one more time. Now, I say this is arguably the most hardest part, but that's only for non-Stan users. As for a Stan user, this would actually be a pretty simple feat, as you could just use your newly acquired ability to carry the lighter in. For someone who hasn't done the test fully, it would be pretty hard to get past the metal detector, luggage scanner, and everything else, not to mention the pat-down. Though, if they opted into buying out the police, this would be pretty much the same as exiting. So if you haven't figured it out yet, the lighter test is actually something set up in so many ways to fail that cheating is the only way that you could possibly pass without having to relight the lighter itself. Which is ironic given the fact that this is a test of trust built on a foundation of lies. Which, like most things in JoJo, things on the surface are not as they appear. As the lighter itself has never actually been the test. It's actually all about the stand that lies within the lighter. Meaning that the test has always been to figure out if you're strong enough to have a stand. And those who choose to ignore the test or cheat their way past the test are those who get punished not by Popo, but the cruel underworld that they'll enter without a stand. Look at Leaky-Eyed Luca for your life expectancy at that point. Now, the lighter itself is actually heavily inspired by the Olympic pastime, the Olympic Torch Run. Here, a runner is given the task of taking a single flame from one place to another without it going out, except for those multiple times where it went out. This tradition was inspired by the story of Prometheus, the Titan who brought fire to man. The fire brought by Prometheus went on to enable the progress of humanity in general, delivering onto them knowledge once not known, and allowing them to progress society immensely, thus giving fire the symbolic meaning of knowledge and progression. Thus is the same about Popo's lighter. As the purpose of a lighter is to create flame or to create knowledge, Popo's lighter's purpose is to create stand users or create new knowledge, as the fire it creates will test the will of the person who relit it, either burning them away in the flames of human progression or shining a light on knowledge once not known, this being the existence of stands. And this is also why Black Sabbath targets anyone who saw the relighting of the lighter. They witnessed the creation of knowledge incarnate, thus they must be tested to see if they can progress humanity as well. Now, there are only two real flaws with the lighter test itself. That being, first, if a person taking the test believes the lighter is a trick lighter, aka a lighter that can only be lit once, they would never attempt to try to relight it if it ever goes out. Though, I say this really only applies to those who really overthink things, as a more natural reaction to the lighter going out would be to obviously attempt to relight it to see if it works. But the second one could actually be abused by those who are more extremely perceptive, as the lighter that Popo used for this test is a gas lighter, and it is always expunging gas from the lighter. So if, say, the lighter goes out, someone could introduce a new flame instead of relighting the lighter and ignite the gas. Though it's very possible that any type of reignition on the lighter would trigger Black Sabbath, so this is only a hypothetical flaw, and even so, if the person were to work around the system, the cheater would be punished by entering a world of stand users without a stand, which is basically a death sentence. Though, interestingly enough, it's very possible that not every Passione member was subjected to this test. In fact, it's very logical that not every Passione member was subjected to this test. In fact, it's very likely that a lot of the gang were just other gangs that were absorbed over time by Passione as it grew more and more dominant over the Naples area. Also, Popo may be an important member to the gang, but he's only one single capo, and there are 756 members in this gang. Popo does not have enough time to test every single one of them, meaning that besides him, there are tons of other capos who need to conduct tests on new gang members. Though, Popo does seem to be the one who gets to choose where he can send people, versus the other ones who likely just have to deal with who they're given. Along with this, people who have stands prior to this and make a name for themselves are likely just asked to join the gang or absorbed by Passione over time. This is seen in both Vladimir Kokake and Masami Volpe, who were stand users who unlocked their stands naturally and were granted high-ranking positions in the narcotics team and allowed to basically recruit anyone they want. Or La Squadra, who seemed to be an operating force prior to Passione's sudden surge of power, and they were just absorbed over time by Passione and worked for them, rebelling against them when they realized they were getting a raw deal out of this. And the only real reason that Giorno had to keep his stand ability under wraps instead of coming forth to Popo with the, hey, I'm a stand user, is the fact that he was the last one scene near Leaky-Eyed Luca when he was murdered, and Bruno was sent to take care of the person who killed Leaky-Eyed Luca, meaning that if Giorno said, hey, I'm a stand user, and I was the last person seen with Leaky-Eyed Luca, I'm basically the guy who murdered him, which would be bad for both Bruno and Giorno. Though with that in mind, this also means there is a very possible timeline where Giorno joined Passione as a stand user, like when Popo's like, do you have any special talents? And Giorno's like, yeah, check this golden guy out, I can do this. They would be placed among the ranks of La Squadra instead of Bruno's gang, which would have been a very different story, probably a lot sadder, and I really want to see it. But anyway, if you enjoyed this video and like to see more videos like it in the future, I have a Patreon at patreon.com/manynotthebadguy. And if you want to join Sox instead of Passione, well, all you have to do is buy a copy of Shimonetta from buyshimonetta.com, and you'll just have to keep it running on, like, your DVD player, your PlayStation 4, whatever you choose to watch videos on, for roughly 24 hours, or else a ghost will come out and kill you.